waiting for the rain to come. You know that India is a land of agriculture. Most of the population of India depends on agriculture. And for agriculture, for good harvest, we need rain as well as sunshine. So let's see the story. I hope it rains at least today, very hot, as he opened his eyes when he was a farmer. Now this is a story of a farmer named Belly. He was waiting for the rain. So he talked to himself and he hoped that it will rain. The sun was beginning to rise, glowing crimson like fire. When you scanned the sky, there was not a cloud. It doesn't look encouraging. He muttered to himself and got up. Now he looked at the sky to see whether it would rain or not. So when he was also looking, early morning, the sun was beginning to rise and it looked crimson like fire. So crimson means deep purplish red. So the sun looked bright. The sun was shining sky. So when you scanned, looked at the sky, but there was not a single cloud in the sky. You know, before the rain, before it rains, you can see number of dark black clouds in the sky. But that day, there was not a single cloud in the sky. So when you talked to himself, doesn't look encouraging. So he was eagerly waiting for the rain because it was very necessary for growing crops. And as there was no cloud, so it was not encouraging. And he muttered to himself and he got up. Rain or no rain, a farmer wakes up early. When he worked hard, his piece of land never failed him. Season after season, he cultivated it, harvesting jowar one season and dal the next. Throughout the year, he worked, never thinking of rest or taking a holiday. For nearly 6 years, he had been sold, ever since he had bought his own piece of land. But this year turned out to be different. Whether it rains or not, a farmer gets up. So when you also used to wake up early every day, he worked hard in his field. He had his own field and he worked in that field really hard to cultivate the crops. He cultivated two crops in his field. One was jowar and the next was dal. Jowar is a food grain by which can be harvested. Dal comes under pulses. So one season he used to cultivate jowar and the next season he used to cultivate dal. So whole year he worked very hard. He did not think of any rest. He was a very hard worker. So for nearly 6 years he had been so that alternate year he was cultivating jowar and the next year he was cultivating the dal. For 6 years, since when he has got his own field, it was going on smoothly. He was working hard and was getting good harvest. But now this year was going to be different. So let's see how it was going to be different. At the end of summer, the rains didn't come. Well, you and his neighbors waiting, but their waiting didn't take days. He walked back to the village tired and dejected. He was was thirsty and the dust made him cough and sneeze. He decided to rest for a while. Did you take different means? Sand was of loss or failure. Now, when you felt rejected, it was very sad. But at the loss, now as there was no rain, you could not cultivate crops and not feed his family. All those years, he had never failed in cultivation. He had a good harvest. But this year, as it did not rain, he could not cultivate. And so he could not feed his family. So he was at a loss. And he felt very sad. So he came back to his village. He started back to his village in a very sad mood. So while walking, he was tired and slow. He was also thirsty. And because of the dust on the road, had cough and was began to sneeze. So he decided to take rest for some time. He saw a large tree. Its shade was cool and inviting. As he sat down, he noticed that an old woman was also sitting there, sheltering from the sun. Her skin was wrinkled, but her eyes sparkled when she smiled. She looked at Mayu. And her smile grew wider, her wrinkles deeper. So, Mayu decided to take a rest. As Mayu decided to take a rest, he saw a tree. The shade of the tree was cool. There was a cool breeze blowing under the tree. And it was inviting. Hence, the people felt to take shelter under that tree. So when he sat under the tree, he noticed an old woman who had wrinkles on her face. So when she smiled at Mayu, her eyes sparkled. And this old lady, she looked at Mayu and her smile grew wider and her wrinkles grew deeper as she smiled. What are you smiling at, Amma? Mayu asked. Without worries, there is nothing to smile about. Yes, you are right. The woman said, the smile in your lips. So Mayu asked the old woman, Amma, why are you smiling? So he said that without praying, there is nothing to smile. Now everyone was waiting. They did not have any food to feed for themselves and their families. So he thought that there was nothing to smile. So the old woman agreed with him and she stopped smiling. I wonder what I have done to deserve this, when you began. I have worked hard and honestly, yet I am being punished. Without the rains, I can't till the land. If I don't till the land, no crop will grow. What might happen to me? How should I feed my family? He asked, somewhat bitterly. He wasn't speaking to anyone in particular, but the old lady thought that he was opening his heart to her. possible. So he was worried what will happen to him and his family. He didn't have any food grain to feed his family. So he was not particularly talking to the old lady. He was just talking in general to himself. But the old lady thought he was opening his heart to her. He was talking to her and he was telling his feelings. He was sharing his feelings with her.
See.